This video is going to be on just simple metric conversions. Most of you have probably done the King Henry die, drinking chocolate milk with the big stair step, and moved your decimal left or right. And essentially that's what we're going to do, but I'm going to do everything with dimensional analysis. So I don't know if you guys even realize a lot of times you're moving your decimal. As you move to the left, that means you're dividing by 10. As you move to the right, it means you're multiplying by 10. So the conversions you would need to know are, first of all, metric would mean we're doing something in meters, liters, or grams, all based on powers of 10. So we're not doing anything in inches or feet. It's all metric stuff. So if you see meters, liters, or grams, now there might be a prefix in front of that. So it might be kilometers or millimeters or centiliters. Okay. The main three prefixes I will use will be the base units, meters, liters, grams, and then kilo, milla, and centa. Will be about the only three prefixes I use. So typically no hecto, deca, deca, just milla, centa, and kilo. So the conversions you should know. You should know how many centimeters are in the base unit. Centa means 100. How many millimeters are in the base unit? There's 1,000 millimeters in a meter. And how many base units are in a kilometer? There's 1,000 meters in a kilometer. Same thing with liters. You should know that there's 1,000 liters in a kiloliter. Okay, so those conversions you need to just know. Same thing with our dimensional analysis here. So if we start with what we know. We have 0.32 kilometers. I will always do a conversion to the base unit. So remember, this label, kilometers, needs to go on the bottom. Our labels have to cancel. So I'm always converting this to the base unit. In this case, our base unit is meters. So now I have to know those. The bigger one is kilometers. So I'm going to say every 1 kilometer, which is quite a ways, kilo means 1,000, contains 1,000 meters. This label cancels, that one cancels. We have meters right here. We're done. 0.32 times 1,000 would be 320 meters. This one, we're going from milliliters to the base unit of liters. Think about what a liter is. Liter is a unit of volume. 2 liter of pop, you kind of know how big that is. So start with what you know, 560 milliliters. That label needs to go on the bottom. We're going to the base unit. So one of these I always have as the base unit. In this case, we're going to the base unit of liters. A liter is bigger than a milliliter, so you say that 1 liter contains, milli means 1,000, contains 1,000 little milliliters. Cancels, cancels. So we're taking 560 times 1 divided by 1,000, which is going to be 0.56 liters. Notice this one is from milla to kilo. So we don't have a base unit there, but I'm still going to use the base unit. So I'm going to start with 1,000 milligrams. Again, this label needs to go on the bottom. I'm always going to the base unit. In this case, the base unit is grams. So we have to know this conversion. A gram is bigger, so we say every gram contains 1,000 little milligrams. Milligrams, milligrams cancel because they're on top and bottom of the fraction. Label over here needs to be grams. Now I'm going from the base unit from grams to kilograms. Now if you knew directly how many milligrams are a kilogram, you could have put that in here. Not something most of us know. Again, you should know the base unit to the other one. So in this case, a kilogram, which is big, contains 1,000 little grams. Cancels, that cancels, we're left with grams on top. So we're taking 1,000 times 1 divided by 1,000 divided by 1,000, so ends up being that. Last one, we have kilometers to centimeters. So we're going from kilometer, which is pretty long, to centimeter, which is pretty small, so we should get a bigger answer. So we have 0.035 kilometers. Again, kilometers needs to go on the bottom. Don't go kilometers to centimeters, go to the base unit, because you should know the base unit. Every 1 kilometer contains 1,000 meters. So if I stop right now, my answer would be in meters. I'd multiply those, get to meters. I want it in centimeters, so I'm going to say meters to centimeters. A meter stick, this long, contains 100 little centimeters. Meters, meters cancel, left with centimeters. Again, 0.035 times 1,000 times 100. It's all ones in the bottom. So we're going to have 3,500 centimeters.